Hello students, today I will explain exercise 8A. Now, in this exercise we have again two parts, 8A and 8B. In the first part, which is today, I will explain the basic construction of a sphere. The sphere is, you know, the ball, okay, like a ball. So I will explain about it in a bit so you will understand. Now, why do we need to know about the construction of a sphere? And for what we need the sphere? Because in exercise 8B, you will be drawing objects based on the sphere. So before we can draw objects based on the sphere, we need to know first how to construct it correctly. The construction, the basic construction of every object is important for us to understand the geometry of the shape, so that later when we change the geometry while we are drawing another object, this basic construction knowledge helps us. And you will see as we go along what am I talking about now. It will become more clear. Now, before we talked about square. What is this? A square, okay? And this is a 2D object. And this semester we talked a lot about 3D objects. So the square become a cube, okay? So this is 2D. This is the 3D version. We also talked about circles already. So, okay? Now, these are 2D, these are 3D objects. Now, the circle in 3D, what it will become? A sphere, okay? This, okay? This is the sphere. So this is square, this is cube, this is circle, and this here object is called the sphere. The three-dimensional objects, the three-dimensional object of the circle. It's the ball and it's called a sphere. Okay, so we did quite a few drawings with cubes. In the previous exercise, exercise 7, we even made a little more difficult objects based on, again, on cubes that we developed after that. Now, the circle, we already also talked about it, how to draw a circle in perspective, which involved first drawing a square and then diagonals and then finding the four points and then drawing the circle. So this is the procedure to draw it in perspective. You already know that. Now, we need to know today how to draw a sphere. Now, we cannot draw a sphere just drawing a circle. If we draw a circle, this is a 2D object, you know. We have to have a procedure to make it look three-dimensional, okay? And now, of course, you can make it freehand, like how I do it now. I draw this, these are called cross-sections, okay? Freehand. But you need to understand how this works. Now, the circle, to draw a circle, okay, you need to first what? Draw a square. Well, this is for 2D. A circle is what? 2D. So if I want to draw a 2D circle, I have to draw a 2D square. Okay, now, if I want to draw a 3D sphere, okay, I have to draw a cube. Okay, so I have to draw first a cube, and then I can draw my sphere. So today, the first thing that we will do is to draw a cube. We have to draw a cube. Then we can start constructing our sphere. So basically, it's very similar to drawing a 2D circle inside a square. We need the square first. Then we find the four points, and then we draw the circle inside. But this is a 2D object. The circle is a 2D object. If we want to draw the sphere, the sphere is what? Made out of a lot of circles, okay? We need a three-dimensional square, which is called a cube. A cube. We need the cube, okay? And inside this cube, we will draw circles, a lot of circles. In the end, they will form a sphere. Once we understand this construction, the next exercise, the 8B, that we will talk about, will become a little more clear, okay? And we will go step by step, so hopefully you will understand. So let me delete this now here. Where is the... Okay, so we are doing what today? Constructing a sphere. So what do we need to do? The first step, to draw a cube. Now, please, you need to draw. It's not that it's a must, but I advise you to draw the cube in isometric. Isometric. Okay, so step one, draw a cube in what? Isometric. Isometric view. So let's do that. Let me draw a cube. Now, what do you remember about isometric? We have the ground line, and then 30 degree line, 30 and 30, and then we will continue our cube. All of you should know this by now. Okay. Try to draw it big so you can see all the details that I will be drawing. So, it's not 100% correct, but I'm drawing freehand. So, this should be a cube that you should draw exactly in isometric view. Now, regarding the size, what size should you make this first edge? You know, leave it, put it in your homework as 10 centimeter, but you can make it a little bigger, like 15, if you have space. But don't make it less than 10. Because if you make it so small on the drawing, you have a lot of details here that you need to draw. It will not be clear. It will not look good. So from here to here, make it 10 centimeter, okay? Okay, now what should we do? What is the next step to draw our ball, the sphere, okay? What should we do? Now, the first thing, we need to draw three what circles inside the faces that here. So I will cut this object And on each face, I will have to draw a circle according to the rules that we learned before. So, okay, now I will have to cut it in the middle like this. Then this cube, we have to cut it like this. Then we have to cut it like this. And then like this. And on each time in the middle. Now, after that, on this face and this face that will result, and this face, I will draw three circles. On each face, one circle, and it will be in perspective. After that, we will connect some of the points, and it will result into a sphere. Now, since this is isometric drawing, it's very easy to find the middle. So, for example, what is the midpoint of this line? Because it's isometric, you know exactly that it is in the middle of this line, okay? Now, if you draw your cube in perspective, in two-point perspective, it will be not in the middle of this line. It will be somewhere here, okay? That's why, to make your life easy, draw as isometric view, the cube, okay? Okay, so the midpoint of this line is here. And this line the same, okay? Or you can draw it parallel. We have to continue the face. So from this point down straight, and you see I also draw the hidden lines of the cube because we need them. Now I need to know from here to here the midpoint also and connect. And then connect these two together. What did I do? I draw a square, okay? So it's like I cut the cube in half, and the resulting here face is a square. Now, I will do the same thing here, okay? So I will use another color so you can recognize them later. Now, the midpoint of this line here, or this line, the same, okay? We will find it. Then. Okay, we will put it up. Okay. Now, the midpoint of this line, and we will connect here. The midpoint of this line with this line, with this point we connect. And the last two points, this point with this point. Now they should connect perfectly if the drawing is done correctly. So here with me, it's not perfect. Okay, so by now we have what? Imagine we cut the cube from two sides, exactly in the middle, from here and from here. And we have this face, the first one that resulted, and we have the second face here. Now we need a third one. Okay, we need three to draw our sphere. So let me use another color. Now what is left to cut? Like this, okay? So the midpoint of this line, from here to here, and the midpoint of this line, okay, and we connect. point on this line. Roughly. It's a rough drawing, but the important thing is the idea. Okay. Let me improve this one a bit. Okay. So this should be this point, the midpoint of this, and this should point be the midpoint of this. Of course, in my drawing, it's not perfect, but never mind. Now, from this point to the midpoint of this line, from here to here. And from this point to this point, this is our third surface that we imaginarily cut through the cube like this. Okay. Now we have to draw circles inside each of these faces. This is something we already know how to do. So let's start, for example, with the red face. Do you see this here? This is a square in perspective. So how do we draw a circle inside? Diagonals, the first step. Draw the diagonals. Okay. This is the midpoint. Okay. Then from here, straight line up. And this point through this point. Okay. Parallel. So we have this point, this, this, and this. So the circle we draw has to pass through these four points. The circle had to pass through these four points. So this is the circle in perspective, and this in this square. Okay. Now let's draw also a circle in the blue face. So where is this one here? This face. Inside we have to draw another circle. So let's do that in the same procedure. So from this point to this point, diagonal. From this point through to this point, diagonal line. Then straight line down. And we already, from this point through this point, through here. So this and this, and where is the other one? Here and here. So these four points, this, 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 and this. These are the four points that our circle has to pass through. So let's draw it. roughly, okay. Of course, yours need to be much more cleaner than this. Okay, let me just check if the video is recording. Okay. So, we did until now two circles. We have one more to go, which is this space here, the green, okay? This here, okay? This space. So, how do we find, how do we draw the circle inside? Again, from this point to this point, diagonal, from this point to this point, diagonal, and then from here, from this line, to find the points. This is the first point, this is the second point, this is the third point, and this is the fourth point that our circle has to pass. Now, we can draw it inside. Roughly, okay, this is it, the circle, inside this face. So, three faces, three circles inside. Now, it started to look a little bit like what I have here. Now here in the middle, okay, this point, it's this point, and it's the center of the sphere, and the center of all the circles. Now, if you draw in the isometric view, this point will be exactly the center point of everything, of all the circles, and it will be the center point of the sphere, and the center point of the diagonals when you draw them from each square face. So it will be the center of everything. If you did this in a two-point perspective, not isometric, it will be a different story. It will be a little more harder to draw. Okay. Now, we haven't finished. Now, what should we do in the final step? We have each of these circles, do you see each of these circles, has a maximum like point. Like if I take here, what is from here to here, it's the maximum point of this circle. It's very important when you draw to draw them very accurately. Not, for example, too long or too short or too pointy. So, the more accurate this drawing here is, the more accurate is the next step. So, from each of these points, you need to mark. So, this point, this here, this, and this. And now, you need to draw a circle, the final circle, around all of them. And if your drawing is perfect from the start, so the cube is perfect, the how you put the midpoints of each side is perfect, and you did the circle perfectly. Now, when you draw this final circle, it will form a perfect circle. If anything is wrong in your drawing, it will look like an egg. It will look a little bit like an egg shape. So you will know that something is wrong in the drawing. So I will have to connect now all the points. course, my circle is not perfect, but it is very close to a good state. So, connecting this final circle with the end points of all our other three circles should form a perfect circle. Now, if you draw this, for example, with a compass, and you see that the other circles inside are a little bit too short or a little bit too long, that means you didn't draw them correctly, okay? So you have to fix your drawing. But what I want in the end is a very clean drawing, as usual. All the lines have to be clean, cleanly made and drawn. And what I want to stand out is, okay, this here, the cube, we need it to stand out heavy, and this here, the final circle of the sphere, the internal circles, these are construction lines, okay, these are the construction lines, a little bit lighter, and all these dotted lines for the diagonals, again, lightly, please, very light lines, but clear lines. Okay, so this is our object. So we understand how to construct a sphere. We have to first draw a cube, because it's logical. If we want to draw a circle in perspective, we have to draw a square and then draw the circle inside. So it's logical that if we want to draw a 3D object, which is a sphere, we also have to draw circles in perspective inside square faces. And because it's a 3D object, this here will be inside a cube. Okay? So, this is it for today. In the next class, in exercise 8B, we will use this sphere to learn how to basically new techniques, and we will make something real out of this, okay? basically robot heads. So next class we will talk about this more. Okay, so this is it for today. Thank you. I will make a photo of this a little bit close up, so you also have this to look at in case.